So if you're an obsessive beer nerd, an avid drinker like me, there is one trend in the beer industry over the past couple years that is impossible to ignore. The rise of the delightfully hazy New England or Northeast IPA. These IPAs set themselves apart not only by embracing juicy citrus flavors that pair perfectly with the bitterness that IPAs are known for, but they also have a distinct haziness that immediately tells the drinker they're in for a juicy IPA experience. But for all the hype that surrounds these brews today, it's strange that drinkers have embraced the hazy appearance. Until recently, haze was a sign of imperfections in the brewing process. As someone who is a huge beer nerd, this got me thinking, what causes haze in beer anyway? And what will the answer to that question reveal about the drinker's newfound obsession with the haze craze? Hey, this is Ryan with Beer by the Numbers, and today we're going to find out what makes beer cloudy and see if embracing that cloudiness might be able to push craft beer in a new direction. There's no doubt we're going to get deep into some chemistry and biology today, so grab your favorite pair of nerdy beer glasses and let's get started. If you've ever brewed your own beer or know someone who does, you've probably seen some cloudy looking homebrews. Most homebrew haze is caused by yeast that has been suspended in the beer as homebrewers don't filter their beers like many commercial brewers do. Of course, we know yeast play a very, very important role in beer. After all, without yeast working their fermentation magic, there would be no beer. As fermentation draws to a close after the yeast have eaten most of the delicious sugars left in the wort, they begin to settle to the bottom of the fermentation vessel. Yeast have a tendency to stick together when times get tough and begin clumping or flocking. To the degree which a yeast forms flocks after fermentation, it's given the term flocculation. Some yeast strains are very good at flocculation while others are not. If you're using a strain of yeast that may lend a great flavor profile, but doesn't flocculate very well, you're going to end up with some hazy looking homebrews. And if you're a homebrewer who's looking for a really crystal clear beer, your best bet is to pick a strain of yeast with good flocculation to avoid a yeast cloud when poured into a glass. Now, if you're an advanced home brewer who is good at removing yeast, or you're a commercial brewer who either filters or has great brewing equipment that promotes flocculation, the haze that clouds your beer is probably not due to yeast. The next most common cause of haze is one that most professional operations spend a lot of time and money combating: protein polyphenols. Now, what in the world is a polyphenol? Well, poly means multiple, and phenol is an aromatic chemical compound that is slightly acidic and makes many different fruit and plants smell really good. Polyphenols are found all throughout nature in various plants, fruits, spices, and they're actually really good for you. They have antioxidant properties that can help repair cell damage, and they have been shown to positively impact gut bacteria as well. And certain polyphenols found in green tea, and yes, even beer, have been said to be really, really good at combating inflammation and heart disease. But because of their prevalence in plants, there is no way to avoid these chemicals ending up in your beer, and sometimes they can contribute to other unwanted reactions. They can add to certain oxygen staling reactions that create compounds that can create haze. These compounds can be even hazier when temperatures are lower, hence why brewers and knowledgeable beer drinkers often describe a beer as having a chill haze. They're talking about these polyphenols. But beer haze can also indicate a more sinister problem: bacterial infections, which can cloud a beer and ruin it with off flavors. For example, Pediococcus demiscus is a common brewery infection that generates large amounts of diacetyl, that unwelcome buttery taste you get in some beers. Lactobacillus can produce an array of flavors alongside its characteristic lactic tartness. A third family of haze-causing bacteria includes chloroform, which produced vegetal off flavors reminiscent of parsnips or celery. Most such bacterial haze develops in the bottle after fermentation, and your only realistic options you have here is to either choke the beer down or dump it out. So which of these causes are the culprit behind the haze craze in these delicious Northeast IPAs? Well, since most commercial brewers do a great job of flocculating the yeast, and they don't have to dump whole batches of beer very often, it must be option number two. A whole ton of polyphenols floating around inside those juicy beers. And actually, this theory makes a lot of sense. There are a ton of polyphenols in all those fruits brewers are trying to pack into those IPAs. Haze is really just a byproduct of trying to make the most aromatically hoppy beer we can, explains Zach Page, director of brewing operations at the Massachusetts-based Trillium Brewing Company. Page has been making hazy New England style IPAs for about 4 years since Trillium opened in 2013. These polyphenols not only lend beer their hazy appearance, but they also add a smooth, creamy bitterness and ease the bitter bite of a lot of different hop varietals. Some brewers even double down on things that bring the haze, like using yeast strains that add fruity esters and particulate matter that end up being suspended in the beer. Alvarado Street Brewery in Monterey, California, and Amplified Aleworks in San Diego recently collaborated on a hazy IPA called Trois Cabrones, a reference to the special strain of yeast used to ferment the beer, Saccharomyces brucellus Trois. This particular yeast, says Alvarado Street brewer Andrew Rose, leaves a distinct fruitiness in the beer along with a pronounced haze so thick that one cannot even see through a 3-ounce sampler of this beer. Late addition hopping is another method that brewers use for New England IPAs. This means hops are added to the beer at the end of the roughly 1-hour boiling process, or sometimes even after that, rather than during the boil, which is the more conventional approach to IPAs. This amplifies aromas while extracting a lot less of the hops' alpha acids, which are responsible for bitterness. This process can also leave microscopic vegetable matter suspended in the beer. Filtration has typically been used to remove this material, but that would remove some of the flavor and haze, and we can't have that. And in a world of crystal clear beers, hazy ones have found a way to stand out, not just in flavor, but in their signature appearance. So the next time you belly up to the bar, order a hazy IPA. That way you know you have not only one of the most flavorful beers on the menu, but the one filled with the most healthy polyphenols. Thanks so much for watching this episode of Beer by the Numbers. I really appreciate you stopping by. If you know a beer lover in your life who has a passion for beer knowledge, it would mean the world to me if you would share the show with them. I love the community of passionate beer lovers that has formed around this channel, and the more the merrier. Once again, this has been Ryan with Beer by the Numbers, and I'll see you next week with more hazy beer content.